Gary, it's absolutely fantastic to have you here with us at the MCM Comic Con. Have you been enjoying it so far?
I have. It's a lot of love here. A lot of great people. A lot of beautiful smiles. It's very warm. And there's stormtroopers walking around. And Darth Vader, I saw him on an escalator.
You've obviously been meeting excited fans. I guess the first question, what are the most common questions you get asked when you do have fans lucky enough to meet you?
I just got asked a question about did I shadow real criminalists and CSIs when I did the show. And mostly people get up and they tell me that they cried when I died and things like that, which is great to hear, you know. When you're an actor, you want to hear that you affected someone in some way, or you got a reaction or emotion out of someone. Then you know you did your job.
CSI is a show that completely changed the landscape in many ways of television and particularly police procedurals. What do you think it was about that show that gave it that instant reaction with fans just all around the world?
Well, I think right at the show's conception, that time we were just reaching a really powerful information age. The computers were really taking over. We were doing the show. There was nothing about tweeting and twittering at the time. You know, there was no way to connect with my fans. But the computer industry was growing so vastly, and information was growing so vastly. We can Google anything nowadays and get an answer. And that was just kind of becoming and budding when CSI was being started. So the science element of the show, I think, was a big hit with people who wanted to know more, who weren't just happy with what they had learned in high school or even college, who wanted more in science. And science is based on facts, you know. So I think a lot of people were interested in that. Maybe the way the show was shot. But I think, as well, someone was asking me, what about the shows were keeping people watching them? And there's a lot of other series on TV, but I think with some other series that you have to watch the whole series in order to get one episode. You have to understand what happened from the previous episodes. But not with CSI. You can watch one episode, and from start to finish, it's the whole episode. So a lot of people became addicted in that way, I think, as well. And then there's also me, of course. Yeah.
The show overall is fantastic. Talking about you, though, I mean, clearly your character, one of the most fascinating elements of the show, I think, because he is so layered. He's very heroic, he's very admirable and charming, but he's also deeply flawed and has inner demons. Can you talk a little bit about what excited you about playing the character and watching him grow over so many seasons?
You know, I was just joking as far as me. When I got started the show, I was really just charged to be able to Jerry Bruckheimer and Billy Peterson to root for me to get the job. And I was charged to do it because I had admired Billy Peterson's work, of course, for years. And, of course, Jerry Bruckheimer speaks for himself. When I got the show, it was a great challenge to be an actor and to be in a drama. You want to be able to play a character who has dimensions. And I was able to do that with that show and play an arc there and play many different storylines that became a sort of a basis for a lot of the shows. A lot of the dramatic arcs were about my character, and I really appreciated that because that gave me something to do every day when I got into work. I really dove into it, something to sink your teeth in, which is what you want. You know, the first year I started having troubles about it. I was like, why is my character always doing bad? But then I started talking to really well-known actors, and I realized why I got into the art form of drama in the first place. It was because of those actors' work. It was because of Sam Jackson's work, Robert De Niro's work, and it was because they played bad guys good. They played characters with flaws fantastic. And that's why I went to Strasbourg, and that's why I got into the art form. And I went back into it headstrong with the newfound, you know, inspiration for what I do, you know, for a living.
Fans will have their favorite episodes, their favorite arcs. Are there any in particular over the course of the series, looking back, that you're especially proud of your work on?
There was, I think it was season two. We did an episode where a director named Charlie Carell, who had never directed any of our episodes, came in to direct. It was an episode that Anthony Zeiker wrote, and the network wasn't going for it at first. It got shelved, and then we were behind. We would usually shoot 23 shows a season, and we were behind. We were up to six or seven, and they needed shows. They pulled it off the shelf, and we shot it with a different crew that we had never worked with before, and it became our first number one show. And it was the first show that my character was a little bit prominent, and he had to take the lead for the day. And Catherine and Grissom had gone out for the weekend for different exhibitions, and I had to be the CSI boss. And it was a hard show for me to shoot because the director kept on pushing me and going, you're the lead in this show, you got to push it up. You can't just kind of throw away your lines, and it taught me a lot It taught me a great deal about being an actor, and taught me a great deal about taking charge and getting the job done. And taught me a lot about what it means to work with a great crew.
You're surrounded by a luminous cast on the show. I mean, people like Billy, and I mean, what made the chemistry, you think, just so perfect between everyone?
Great question. I'm not exactly sure what made the chemistry as good as it did, but I know that there was a fantastic chemistry. I think that that's what made the show for me. And I think that comes across on screen. I think that's why a lot of people like it. We got along great. We had a great time. And we were the underdog. We started out the show, and we were not the favorite of the network. And they had wanted Billy to be on another show, The District. And Billy didn't want to be on The District. And I think he'd even shot a day on The District and was like, this is not for me. I want to do that show, CSI. And the network was like, that show is not going to go anywhere. You don't want to do that, Billy. And he's like, he stuck to it. And then I got on it, and we shot a season. And we were clearly not the favorite of the network, but we kept on pushing it out. And then after a few episodes, it became apparent that we were going to do something. And it took a couple years for them to come around. The fans all loved it. And the rest is history.
Fans are going to be desperate to know where they're going to get to see more of you. They need more. They need more Gary. Where are we going to get it?
I'll just tell them to keep their eyes open. I'm always involved in something. I've been doing some music projects and bit parts here and there on different TV shows for different networks, you know, and just having a good time with life.
It's a question that young actors would probably want to have answered. What advice would you give them? I mean, obviously, they'd be delighted to follow in the footsteps of your success, but I mean, what advice would you give to people just starting out in the industry and trying to get their big break, trying to land a part in a major series, trying to do, you know, what you're doing so well?
I'm going to pass on the advice that I got from great people like Debbie Allen and Robert De Niro and Sam Jackson. It's just tenacity. Tenacity is king. Debbie Allen taught me to audition for everything, even if you don't think you're right for it, just to get experience. Robert De Niro taught me to get your picture and your headshot and your resume and send it out to as many casting directors and go visit them as much as you can. Tenacity works, you know. Your drive is going to mean more than anything. Your ambition is going to mean more. And you can make up with the talent after you get along and you get a job and, you know, you get some experience. The talent, you know, will come after the ambition.
A message to fans, particularly I guess fans of CSI watching this all around the world, anything you'd like to say to all those wonderful people?
Absolutely. Thank you so much for watching all these years. You've kept me alive and you kept my family very happy and smiles all around, and you've given me a lot of support and a lot of love, and I give it right back to you. Thank you so much. You're a king.